This Women's History Month, a former Kansas City, Missouri police officer is taking control of her future after suffering a personal tragedy. KSHB News reporter Jian Kim shares her story.
What went through your mind after somebody told you, hey, this is what you went through?
The injury is hard. I think the loss of a profession, the loss of friends, the loss of a potential future that you might have with something, I think that's extremely difficult.
Ever since she was a little girl, all Kate Wong ever wanted to be was a cop. Wong had found her purpose as a patrol and undercover officer at KCPD, but that changed in an instant in June of 2003.
You remember things in flashbacks, kind of short, like 1 or 2 second bursts of what happened on scene. Remember smells.
Wong and her partner were ambushed while ticketing a vehicle. She suffered a front-to-back closed head injury.
It's devastating.
She was eventually medically retired from KCPD, just shy of earning additional stripes. Wong was the only Asian woman on the force back then and would have been the first Asian to become sergeant.
I will say that I've had difficulties being an Asian American female growing up.
Her saving grace was found here at the Adaptive Training Foundation in Dallas, Texas. The nonprofit provides free, holistic training programs for veterans and first responders with traumatic injuries.
She's a beast, I'm not gonna lie. She doesn't quit and she doesn't complain at all.
For the first time in years, Wong felt like she had community. It's how she met current KCPD officer Tyler Moss, who also suffered a TBI on the force in 2020.
We connected on that traumatic injury, but also connected on just being police officers. You know, it's a special bond that we'll have for the rest of our lives together.
While the road to recovery and self-discovery was anything but easy, Wong tells me she needed the lows to appreciate the highs.
So where are you today?
I'm probably one of the best places that I've been in forever.
Jian Kim, KSHB 41 News.